YouTube, it's Hannibal Bonaparte, and I'm bringing you guys this commentary video here for Shogun 2 Total War. I'm actually going to try and show you guys two really cool battles here. I am playing in this with the Heir of Carthage. You guys will probably know him, most of you, if not all of you. So, I played, I think, 5 or 6 battles with the Heir of Carthage the day before Easter, 2v2s. And I only managed to save 2 of the replays because of time requirements, but I'll show you guys them now. Okay, so you can see that this was a 2v2 on the rice fields map. This was a lobby game, not match made. So you can see us on the left side, Shogun, Wizard of Kane. So that's us, and then we're playing against TheoGN8219 and WolfZB. TheoGN8219 is a 5-star. Or a 6-star, or 5-star, something like that. And WolfZB is an 8-star. And they bring 2 vastly different kinds of armies. I got to play against the 5-star, WolfZB got to play against, Heir got to play against WolfZB. And the cool thing about this battle, or our set of battles, was that we were actually voice chatting. So, not only was that cool in and of itself, but we were also able to plan our strategies, techniques, etc., even more closely than the battle that the Heir of Carthage showed or posted of us two playing together a little bit earlier. Anyways, we're gonna head down onto the battlefield. Okay, so you can see this is our combined forces over here. You can see that he is in command of the purples, and I'm in command of the reds over here. You can see that here I've got my Boashigaru up front. I have 5 of these Boashigaru. 4 of them are non-veterans, these you see here, and one of them is a veteran all the way down there at the end. Then I have 3 units of Yarashigaru. These guys are all veterans. I have 5 Chevron. This is the 5 Chevron Yarashigaru. Then I have a 7 Chevron and a 6 Chevron. Then I have a veteran Katana Samurai, veteran Lone Sword, and veteran Nodachi. Those are my sword infantry. On the right flank, I've got a Naginata Warrior Monk veteran with 6 Chevrons there. They're going to hide in the forest. Behind them, I have a special unit. I have a 6 Chevron Katana Hero unit here. Those guys are very powerful, and they're going to do a lot of good work this game. In terms of cavalry, I have 2 units of cavalry. I've got 2 great guards, one with 5 chevrons, this one, and one with 4 chevrons, that one. These guys are also going to do some pretty good work for me this game. And then, of course, I've got my avatar, who is right now actually going out for a worthless charge. It doesn't really do anything, but there he goes. The Heir of Carthage's army is over here, this is TheoGN's army over here, and I'm actually going to pause it to show you guys what he basically has. So, let's see what he has. He has lots and lots of sword infantry. So he's got 1, 2, 3, 4 Katana Samurai, Lone Sword, 5, 6, 7 Katana Samurai, then he got some Bow Samurai, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 Bow Samurai. More sword infantry, Katana Samurai, Lone Sword Ashigaru, and his avatar is up there. Then this is WolfZB's army over here. He's got a cavalry unit and his avatar. So he's got these Yai cavalry right here, avatar bow warrior monks, upgraded Katana Samurai, and a special unit here, Yari Hero. You can see that guy's the Yari Hero himself. And let's look at the Wizard of Kane's army, or Heir of Carthage's. He has 2 units of these bow units here, Bow Ashigaru, Death from Above, and Arrow in Your Eye, Bow Ashigaru. He's got a couple of cavalry units heading off to the left. Then he has some Naginata Samurai, 3 of those, 4 of those, 5 of those. And then he's got some nice matchlocks. He's got 3 matchlock warrior monks and a depleted matchlock rifles, Apache's rifles. So here are his matchlock warrior monks. Then he has 3 units of Yari Samurai here in the back. And, of course, his avatar, which he so lovingly calls Patchy. It's right up there. Now let's head on over to the action here, which is I tried to charge my general out because I thought that my opponent might be foolish enough to keep his general there. Now you can see strategically that we've kept our armies kind of bunched together. We're not really spreading out our armies too much, and that's because we don't really want to make... My opponent has kind of balled up his forces, so I want to keep a strong core as well. You can see now that my opponent here is maneuvering around in column formation, which is very it's not a very good move, but it can be powerful in some situations. Overall, it's really, really bad, but it can smash its way through a Yari wall, for example. You see there my archers firing off at this Lone Sword Ashigaru. First volley, I don't do too much, just 7 casualties here. The next volleys are absolutely devastating. There we go. And that did a little bit. Then this one's next. Oh, man, that did a lot there. So this Yari Ashigaru's lost 40 men. And more volleys going to be coming in very soon. There we go. And more from the left side over there. This unit is now down to 60 out of 150, so 110 casualties there, and it's absolutely demolished. It's going to rout. It's Katana Samurai. He's making a big mistake here. They're just walking up, just allowing my archers more time to shoot at him. I'm not going to withdraw my archers away just yet. I'm going to use them to their full potential, and now I'm going to withdraw them. You can see I'm going to withdraw them all behind my line. And my Yari Ashigaru are going into the Yari wall formation just to try and hold up his Katana Samurai. My guys are veterans, so they will probably do very well against the Katana Samurai. So you can see there he's going to march up with his units. And over there, that's a leading unit on his left side. And you can see my Katana Hero is going to just charge out and meet them head on. So I'm charging my Katana Hero out in front of my line so he can get do as much damage as possible. My Katana Hero is absolutely going to destroy these Samurai units here. It's like amazing. So every single place you look, it's my Katana Hero destroying a Katana Samurai unit. It's very, very cool. Oh, that guy just got owned. My Katana Hero is now fighting against two Katana Samurai and doing very well. Over here, he smashed his Katana Samurai in, and as you can see, he smashed right through my Yari wall. And over here on my left flank, Heir of Carthage sent in some cavalry to go disrupt this Katana Samurai blob over here. I'm going to help him out with my Great Guard over here. They're charging in over there. And there are four chevrons at the time this battle was played. And here's my 5 chevron Great Guard. Back to the action. You can see on my right flank, he's been destroying my warrior monks with his archers. Good idea there. You can see them writhing in pain. Now he's going to bring them in against my Yari wall, so I'm going to charge in my Naginata now for melee. They're still taking some casualties from archers, but they're going to get in nonetheless. They're going to war cry, and they're going to pretty much demolish those guys. Here's my Katana Hero. It's only lost 7 men after destroying 2 Katana Samurai units, and it's going to keep its work going. And our cavalry over there is just wrecking up that Katana Samurai. Heir did lose a cavalry unit in there, but it's nothing major. And here you can see I launched a hammer and anvil with my Yari my Great Guard, into his Katana Samurai, and that's going to rout that blob of units. And just like that, my opponent's army, the massive army, is pretty much finished. You can see his units are now routing off the battlefield on this flank as well because of a Katana Hero hammer and anvil. You can see them running after. All my opponent has left is his avatar here, which I'm catching up to with my cavalry and destroying. Yeah, you can see it's pretty cool. I do really like the cavalry animations. Occasionally, they're overplayed. It seems like there's more variation in sword hand-to-hand combat, but there are some pretty cool animations there as well. Okay, so over on this flank, you can see that Wolf ZB is sending out his cavalry far onto our combined left flank over there. You can see that he's got 2 Yari cavalry and 1 Great Guard. And in the center here, Heir's units are getting torn up by the enemy archers, by warrior monks. But he is eventually going to win this because he's got more numbers. Here comes an enemy cavalry unit. Heir is going to withdraw his Bow Ashigaru behind his lines, send forward his Naginata Samurai. So Wolf ZB does retreat. Good reactions there, but they get torn up as well. Here my general is just finishing off the last of my opponent's forces here, both Samurai. And my general is pretty much... he's amazing right now. Although unfortunate things happened to him in this battle. Anyway, so my opponent is completely finished off now. And now it's just time to work together on Wolf CB's army. Okay, so you can see I'm going to send over all my units into this area. So you can see that the archer fight is continuing. And over here, this is a pretty cool development. Heir and I were laughing and planning our strategy here. You saw that his warrior monks were actually positioned facing towards the back, and now he's going to send out his general to look vulnerable, and his opponent here with his Yari cavalry is going to buy it hook, line, and sinker. Over here you can see that he's bringing up more cavalry to go in and charge at my general. Let's go back to this action. Wolf CB bought it. He didn't know that these matchlocks were facing their way, so here these matchlocks are get absolutely devastating shots off against the Yari cavalry, which is now going to charge headlong into these spears here, futilely trying to catch Patchy, and Patchy is going to run free. Okay, over here, you can see my general is just chasing away the last bow samurai. But here comes the Yari cavalry. My general's not fast enough. He does have 2 skill points in speed, but he's still not fast enough to escape these Yari cavalry, so I had to countercharge. My general is a legendary swordsman, and he's going to do a lot of damage. You can see him right there, actually. But he can't take on, in his depleted form, I think he had only 19 guys left. In his depleted form, he can't really take on 3 Yari cavalry, veteran Yari cavalry, single-handedly. Over here, you can see his, I just killed his avatar. I killed his avatar with my great guard. Here I made a strike in, killed his avatar, and I withdrew. So that was a very successful assassination mission. Proves that you don't need ninja to take out a general with a straightforward attack. You can see here that his Yari cavalry is demolishing my general right over there. And now I'm going to get my katana hero in to his katana samurai from behind. So here my katana hero goes. He's going to absolutely demolish these guys as well. Remember, he's only lost 7 men, so he's still 23 men strong. And everywhere you look, katana samurai are dying. It's crazy. Like, 6 of them are dying right now. There goes another one. And my katana hero is incredibly outnumbered, but it's 6 chevrons are not for nothing. So it could probably beat them by itself, but in the background here, I just love these animations. But anyways, in the background here, you can see that Heir is bringing up his troops over here. He's got his Naginata samurai in the background, and my katana hero is still fighting, but his Naginata samurai is soon going to pour in from behind to catch these routing katana samurai. So my katana hero did rout them, and Heir's gonna finish them off with his troops here. So that's the end of Wolf ZB's infantry forces. Over here you can see I did charge in my great guard to try and just do as much damage as possible to these Yari cavalry. That didn't go too well, but that's okay. Over here you can see that his Yari cavalry is now trying to take out my archers, which is actually a smart move. Unfortunately for this Great Guard unit over here, this is Great Guard. Unfortunately for it, I've got all my archers trained on it and it's going to die pretty quickly. Oh, look at that guy, he just went down. These guys are going to die really quickly, but it's smart for him to try and be taking out my bows because you can see him charging with all of his Yari cavalry right now. It's smart for him to be, let me try and finish my thought. These bows are my only long-range units, the only units that are capable of catching him at this point, because we've used up almost all of our cavalry. So he could practically just run around forever now that my bows are gone. That was a pretty smart move by him. And you can see that I'm bringing in my units to try and support. Here's a Yari Ashigaru unit that I managed to catch him with briefly. But because he's lost his whole entire army, these units are suffering from army loss morale. You can see him right here, he's just chasing down the last of my bow Ashigaru here. Ooh. Yeah. Ooh, that guy just got owned. Anyways, you can see them. They're going to just chase down the last of these enemy, of my bow Ashigaru. But you can see that Heir of Carthage's army is completely intact. 113 men there, 87. He's got full units here and there. He didn't really do too much fighting in this battle. There's my katana hero. It's only lost 18 men, so it still has 12 remaining, still ready for action. But we have massive forces against these Yari cavalry units, so they're suffering from a overwhelming defeat is certain, sort of. You can see him there, he's just chasing down the last of my units. Oh, that guy just got destroyed. Stabbed in the back. But you can see that his units are suffering. You can see that this unit's now routing from army losses. This unit here is wavering, and what Heir's going to do now is he's going to send in his general. He just learned at this moment that his general could inspire himself. So he's inspired himself, and there he charges. There's Patchy himself, and Patchy got rammed into, but Patchy actually survives this, which is, we were laughing about it. Patchy usually dies in the most unusual circumstances, but never dies in the most common ones. Anyway, so we caught up to the Yari cavalry with my Yari Ashigaru, saved Patchy, and his cavalry is now running to the hills. Anyways, that was the end of the battle. Thank you very much for playing WolfZB and TheoGN, and of course Heir of Carthage. I actually have another battle to show you, the second replay that I saved of our 6. And I'll show you guys that right now. Okay, so let's see. There we go. It's actually in the a matched battle here. So unfortunately, the unit sizes will be small, but tactics are still there. Ender does fighting in this battle. And as you can see, that we're playing against Friedlander Paul and Joe Fiel. It was actually interesting because Friedlander Paul is an 8-star, and he is of the clan that my clan, AA, is currently fending off to be first in our tier. So it was kind of cool. It was a pretty fun matchup. Joe Fiel over here is a 5-star or 6-star, and Friedlander Paul is an 8-star. And that's not really matched because Wizard of Kane or Heir is an 8-star and I'm a 9-star, but it was fun nonetheless, and it's on the Koyazin Temple map, which makes it even better. So basically what our plan was just to go straight for the high ground, not care about the low ground and the archery dojo. And we brought pretty independent armies, as you'll see shortly. So we're actually going to drop down on the battlefield, and then I can show you guys that. Okay, so you can see I'm here in this red army again. You can see my troops marching up, and Heir's over there in the purple army. I'm going to pause it now and show you guys my army. I have 3 units of Yar Yashigaru, the same that you saw in the last battle. 5 chevrons, 6 chevrons, and 7 chevrons. You can see them there. Then I have behind them 2 units of Bow Ashigaru. Nope, not those guys. Those guys. And those guys are not veterans. They're just bows. And then I have 2 Yari Samurai, not veterans either. There they are. Pretty cool. And then I have 4 units of these Lone Swords Ashigaru. So I have a heavy sword component. And of course my avatar right there. The Daimyo, as he's actually called. Let's go look at Heir's army. He has out here a Matchlock Ashigaru, Pachi's Gatsugun. And most of his troops are actually in this woods here, so I'll just read them off to you. He has some Yari Samurai, I think he has 3 Yari Samurai, 2 Naginata Samurai. Most of them are veterans. Then he has 2 Bow Ashigaru. Yeah, Bow Ashigaru. Then he's got his avatars over there and 2 Yari Cavalry units over here. So those are our, oh wait, I forgot, here's my cavalry. I've got 2 great guards here, each 5 chevrons. So this light blue one is actually, you guys saw that in the last one, it was only 4, so now it's 5. Let's go look over here. That's the last battle. Friedlander, Paul, the 8-star, here he's got some Matchlock Ashigaru, Rifles of Doom, Blue Rain, Bow Samurai, Rain of Death, Bow Samurai. Here's a Katana Hero unit, right there, it's called Paul Friedlander. Nice. Then he's got some White Warrior Katana Samurai, the Great Wall Yari Hero, the Great Wall Naginata Warrior Monks, and Paul, his avatar's bodyguard. Evidently, this guy likes the name Paul. He's got 5 units, Bow Ashigaru, this guy over here, this 5-star, and a Matchlock Samurai. Then he's got 4 units of Yari Samurai and 2 Katana Samurai, and of course, his avatar's right there. Okay, so as you can see here, we're both rushing for the high ground over here. My army's kind of blocked up right now. Pretty soon I'm going to expand it. And, you can see here I'm going to take up those are my Yari Ashigaru. I'm going to try and send them up there as well. And behind them are my Lone Sword Ashigaru. And, meanwhile, over here, Heir is actually up on the higher ground. And my Yari Cavalry over here are struggling. I was trying to move them secretly. Anyways, you can see Heir is moving all the way up here onto the high ground to try and get the biggest height advantage over these 2 players. You can see them marching up right now. They didn't have too great of teamwork going on, whereas Heir and I did have some good teamwork. We stayed together. Of course, we were voice chatting, so we could really plan our strategies out on the go without having to stop and type. Anyways, you can see I'm still marching up to try and claim the shrine. That's the shrine up there. Increases the morale of all your units in the area. They're marching up as well. Not quite as orderly. You can see there they go. They're going to march up with the Matchlock Ashigaru first. And all the units kind of follow up behind. You can see now that I'm going to actually move my army up into 2 groups. Here are my Yari Ashigaru. Those are my Yari Ashigaru. You can see them. They're going to start running up there. So I'm going to put them up onto the higher ground. I'm going to also follow that up with my Bow Ashigaru. So I'm going to move both my Yari Ashigaru and my Bow Ashigaru up to the high ground. And over here, my Great Guard. They're going to keep moving along there. At first, I was just trying to keep them hidden, but I got fed up. They were moving too slow, so I ran them out here. So you can see that I'm moving up to the high ground. Heir's moving up to the high ground, and we're gonna try and get as many of our forces above theirs as possible. And you can see here my general, his view of the battlefield. Anyways, the action doesn't get started yet, but it's gonna get started actually really soon. You can see Heir's army there. He's got his archers up in front. He's got his Yari cavalry moving around the flank here. And this player, the 8-star, he wasn't really impressive to me personally. I've played against 8-stars that really give me a run for my money. I've played against 8-stars that beat me. This guy didn't have it figured out. You can see here he's running forward with Matchlock Ashigaru into range of Heir of Carthage's Balashigaru veterans. And these guys are going to get absolutely pwned. Like, these guys get destroyed very quickly. I've got my my Balashigaru shooting on them as well. And you can see that the first volley only took out four, but the second volley, going to come in very soon. That wasn't it. That was it. It just took out, they lost 10 men. You can see that he's returning his own fire arrows, but it's not going to be enough. That Matchlock Ashigaru was a big part of his army, actually. It was the shocking core of his army, and you can see right there they just shattered with 23 men remaining. And you can see that he's now just bonsai charging forward, which is allowing both Heir and I to shoot at his really expensive units, like the Katana Hero. So this Katana Hero is actually going to lose one-fifth of his men before actually entering combat. So you can see there he goes. He's going to go up and charge. Over on my side, I had to withdraw away from the shrine because my opponent moved up all of his missiles and was threatening to absolutely destroy my army. You can see my archers are firing back, not at the white guy, but at this 8-star. And he's actually engaged with his Naginata warrior monks here against the Naginata samurai, and he would win that, even with the downhill advantage. So I'm going to take my Yari Ashigaru here. We're going to downhill charge into the Naginata warrior monks there and finish them off. Over here you can see my Yari samurai are being a sacrificial unit, and they're going to stand there and sustain their sustained fire just to win us the shrine. You can see here that this guy's general, the A-star's general here, Friedlander Paul's general, is just routing now. His general actually survives. And I'm not trying to be mean to him, but his play really wrecked their team. He didn't time it well, and because he didn't time it well, his unit suffered from a lot of archer fire before actually going in. Here you can see that I'm going to use my cavalry now. I'm going to put this unit into the wedge formation, try and slide through that gap, but when I realize that I can't because he's bringing Yari Samurai back, I'm just going to slam to the side of that Yari Samurai. But that's merely a distraction. I'm going to get them out pretty much immediately. You can see I did a lot of damage, actually. But I'm going to get them out immediately because here's my real threat. I'm going to try and take out these archers here with my other Great Guard. So we're going to do a lot of damage there. And I'm going to try and kill the general now. My main goal was to kill the general. I got a couple units and a couple men in there, but not enough. And at this point, now that his archers are now that his archers are in melee with my cavalry, now is the time to charge forward everything. You can see my Great Guard are circling around. Here's my Avatar. My Avatar, with his amazing charge and melee statistics, is now going to charge in to this to the spear mess, and he's invulnerable to spears, so he's going to do amazingly in there. And when I say invulnerable, he just doesn't take any penalties from spears. It's not like spears can't hurt him at all. They hurt him as much as a katana would. And you can see here, cinematic view of my epic Yari Ashigaru charge. Yari Ashigaru only get one charge bonus, so it's much better to keep them in the Yari wall and let people charge onto them than to actually charge. But you can see that I've gotten in there. Here's my my Great Guard, excuse me, and they just managed to assassinate the enemy general. And now we're going to just absolutely demolish the Yari Samurai here. I'll get you some close-ups here. Now, I'm using lower quality troops, except for my Yari Ashigaru, who are upgraded to the point of being the equals to Yari Samurai, or more than the equals in some cases. But we are still going to chop these Yari Samurai up, especially since their general just died. They're going to take lots of penalties from morale penalties. My general is in there. Great Guard are hammering and anviling, and these guys are going to chop up his... Ooh, jeez. These guys are just going to destroy the last of his army. So that was the end of that battle as well. It was a fun, very fast battle. Once again, I didn't understand some of the points in there, but you guys got to see Heir fight a little bit. You got to see me fight a little bit. And it was a really, really fun battle overall. So I want to thank all of our players in this video, and the Heir of Carthage especially, for giving me this battle.